Also, the Colts and Texans tied for their first game of the season. Also, the Colts and Texans. Oh my gosh.
Texans.
I'll just do it tomorrow.
Lights. Camera. 3, 2, 1. Action.
Welcome
to
MMS
News
Now.
Roll
the
intro.
Welcome, MMS, and good welcome to you, Ava.
Good welcome to you, Nick.
And we are back with Season 10 of your favorite 7th leading middle school news program, MMS News. And let's see what character trait we are starting with this month.
Remember, we should still be focusing on character traits, even though we should still be 6 feet apart and could be under a mask. This month's character trait is trustworthiness.
Trustworthiness means a person that is honest and who can be entrusted with anything of importance. Go to the MMS News website and fill out the survey to see your name scroll across the screen.
We can't wait to see what kind of trustworth students we have here at MMS.
Want to know what is happening next week at MMS and don't want to pay attention to any sort of announcements? Then get ready for the MMS News Updater with super special Season 10 All-Star Blowout special guest. Welcome back, MMS. It's great to be back and running. Your week ahead is here to tell you what's happening next week with Dr. Glover. On Monday, there's Homer Club, MMS News, and a volleyball game at Johnsburg.
Tuesday, we have Homer Club, Trojan Super Fans, Comic Book Club, Drama, Mad Club, Reading Club, a cross country meet, soccer, and intramural volleyball. A lot of stuff happening on Tuesday.
Wednesday, there's superfans at a game and volleyball versus Parkland.
Thursday, we have golf, soccer, Homer Club, drama, and Pride Club for 6th and 7th grade only. Also, intramural volleyball. And listen, we have open house curriculum night for your parents. So make sure you or encourage them to come see your teachers on Thursday night.
What's so funny?
Go ahead.
Friday, there's a cross-country meet at Johnsburg. Have a great weekend, MMS, and remember to stay involved.
The spotlight is shining bright with this week as our interview crew went straight to the sun with this week's amazing MMS superstar. So put on your shades and get ready.
Hello, MMS. Today we'll be interviewing Dr. Glover, our school's principal.
Hello, MMS. This is Dr. Glover, and I'm honored to be here on the first episode of MMS News to just welcome you guys. That's really not welcoming to you to the school year. We've already been here for a month, right? But I do want to just reach out and say I hope everybody's having a great start to their school year. We have cross country and volleyball competing their tails off and doing a great job. We have all these activities and clubs going on. I'm here at the MMS News Studio today. So many cool things happening in our school, and it is so awesome to see everybody back. Sometimes I forget how cool it is to see everybody's faces and we not wearing masks. It's been awesome. I miss that. I hope everyone's had a great start to their school year. Just to remind you guys, there's so many things and people you can get help from if you need help. My door is always open. I'm answering emails from you guys if you have questions. Mrs. McGann, Mrs. Baird, all your teachers are here to help you. I finally feel like most of you have your locker combinations figured out, so kudos for that. Great job. But if you have any questions or needs to help make this school year that much better, just please reach out and let us know. Last but not least, I think that most of you talked about Thank You Thursday in your home bases. I just want to keep encouraging that. I think it's important to have gratitude in everything that we do. And I want to say thank you to all of you for having this year start off with such a great note. And make sure that you are thanking your families, your friends, just being grateful for all the good things that are happening this school year. So keep up the great work, MMS. Very proud of you guys. And go Trojans.
Thank you, Dr. Glover, and goodbye, MMS. We will see you next week with another staff member.
With the library open and the book fair over, that can only mean one thing. Our book reviewer is back with 1,000 new reads for you to check out this year, so get a pencil and paper to write down this week's page-turning recommendation.
Hello, MMS. I hope you had a great summer, and welcome to Season 10.
This week, I will be reviewing Ground Zero by Alan Gratz. On September 11, 2001, Brandon, a 9-year-old, was at work with his dad at the World Trade Center in New York when two planes hit the tower and he and his dad had to find out how to escape. In present-day Afghanistan, a 11-year-old girl is growing up in the shadow of war. One day, she finds a wounded American soldier and brings her to her house. She and her family are put in danger. What will happen to her? With a 4.3 star review on Goodreads, I give it 4.5 stars. If you have any recommendations, email me at tcrpent899@d15.org. Have a great weekend, MMS. Have fun and keep reading.
Don't want to mess with lots of pages or need some images to help enhance the story? Then worry not, our very own comic updater has you covered this week.
Hello, MMS, this is your comic updater. Today we'll be talking about Booster Gold from DC Comics. He is a time traveler from the future. Booster Gold's real name is Michael John Carter. He has powers like supernova flight, energy blast, force field, enhanced strength, time travel, enhanced vision powers, and visions. Booster Gold has been a member of the Justice League. Booster Gold's first appearance is Booster Gold number 1, February 1986. That's all of us. See you next week. Keep reading comics.
Want to stay dry and keep it chill? Then flip on the TV and turn this latest movie review from our very own movie crew.
Hello, MMS.
Welcome to the first episode of the movie crew from MMS News. This week's movie is Drifting Home.
Drifting Home is about one fateful summer. A group of elementary school kids set adrift on an abandoned apartment building and must look within themselves to find a way back home.
Will they find a way back home? Find out today, September 16th, 2022. And you can watch it for no cost on Netflix. And if you have any movie recommendations, please email me at blarick706@d15.org.
Or email me at lfries965@d15.org.
Bye, MMS! Stay safe and keep watching movies!
The jams are the jammest, the beats are beating, and the speakers are screaming, which means it's about that.
Don't you dare!
Time for your first top 10 of the season.
Welcome to season 10 of the MMS News. Our longest-running story of all time, the top 10, with your guest host, me, Mr. Kenny. Don't get too attached. I'm just filling in until the mighty and powerful Mr. Reardon can find a worthwhile replacement for the amazingness that was our host last year. Okay, on with the music. Our number 10 song this week is I Like You by Post Malone, featuring Doja Cat. I hit you when I land, can you fit me in your plans? I like you, I do. We went up out of France and we woke up in Japan. I like you, I do. Our number 9 song this week is Stayin' Alive by DJ Khaled. I'm staying alive, I'm staying alive, I'm staying alive, I'm staying alive. Yeah. Try me 100 times. Song this week is dedicated to our friend of the show, Marissa, and it's As It Was by Harry Styles. It's just us, you know, it's not the same as it was in this world. It's just us, you know, it's not the same. Number 7 song is Maniac by Macklemore. All the things you do, put me in a hearse, we both cuckoo, cuckoo. It's never gonna work. I wanna dance with a maniac. The moment we touch, it's a heart attack. You know I love you. Number 6 is Sunroof by Nicky York and Daisy. I'm feeling like this might be my time to shine with you. Midway through this fabulous list, it's number 5, Bad Habit by Steve Lacy. I bite my tongue, it's a bad habit. Kinda mad that I didn't take a step at it. Our number 4 song is I Ain't Worried by One Republic. I should be scared of
3 song is Break My Soul by Beyoncé! Our number 2 song this week is Running Up That Hill by Kate Bush. Our first season 10 number 1 song of the year is Hold Me Closer by Elton John and Britney Spears! Well, this has been amazing! But like Sparta, all good things have to end no matter how strong you are. So until next time, this has been the Top 10.
Our one and only gaming master at Blizzard is thumb to spend all summer long making sure that you know the best and greatest games to be playing, so plug it in and pay attention.
Hello, MMS. Today we are going to be reviewing a game called Multiversus. Multiversus is a multiplayer fighting game where you can buy new characters to use them in battle.
There are many characters such as Batman, Shaggy, Bugs Bunny, Harley Quinn, and many more, and they have recently added Morty.
Each character has abilities specific to the character, like Shaggy can power up. The game was released July 19th, 2022, and it's free on all platforms. And that is all. See you next time.
Can't handle all the online gaming or amazing graphics or billions of hours of gameplay? Then worry not. Our retro gamer is ready to take you back to a simpler time. Hello, MMS. Welcome back to Retro Gaming.
Today we will be reviewing Paper Mario for the Nintendo 64.
Paper Mario was released by Intelligent Systems in 2001.
The game is an RPG-style game with a turn-based battle system.
The story takes place in the Mushroom Kingdom, where Bowser has stolen the powerful Star Rod to make him invincible, as he steals Princess Peach and raises Peach's castle in the sky.
Mario must save Peach and recover the magic Star Rod in order to free Peach and stop Bowser.
Partners were also included in the game, like Koops the Koopa Troopa, to boost Mario's turn in battle. That's all for this week, MMS.
Be sure to keep your controller plugged in and have fun.
The field is still wet, but the games keep going, so get your point sheet ready for the first official sports rundown of the year as we throw it to the MMS Sports Center.
And welcome to Season 10.
Yes, we are back and we have a lot to cover from the summer, so let's get right into it.
In the NFL, the Bears got their first win of the season with a 19-10 comeback victory over the 49ers at a very slippery Soldier Field.
The Packers lost to the Vikings 23-7 as Aaron Rodgers can't run the offense effectively without star wide receiver Devontae Adams.
Wait, are you saying the Packers lost and the Bears won? I see why the Packers almost traded Aaron Rodgers.
The Packers will play the Bears at Lambeau Field on Sunday night. The Vikings will play the Eagles on Monday night.
The Lions lost to the Eagles 38-35. They will play the Commanders on Sunday.
In other games, the Steelers and Bengals both missed game-winning field goals before Steelers kicker Chris Boswell kicks a last-second field goal to give them a 23-20 win.
Also, the Colts and Texans tied for their first game of the season 20-20.
In the MLB, the playoff race is heating up.
Over the summer, there were some big trades. The biggest one was the Washington Nationals trading Juan Soto and Josh Bell to the Padres for some prospects and a first baseman, Luke Voit.
Another trade was the Brewers trading Josh Hader to the Padres for Taylor Rogers. So it was a big trade between all-star closers.
The Cubs will more than likely not make the playoffs because as of Sunday afternoon, the Cubs were 18 games out of a wild card spot.
The White Sox are just 2.5 games out of first place in the AL Central behind the Guardians.
In the NHL, the Colorado Avalanche beat the Tampa Bay Lightning in 6 games to win the Stanley Cup.
In the NBA, the Golden State Warriors beat the Boston Celtics to win the NBA Finals.
In the WNBA, the Sun beat the Sky 3-2 in the conference finals.
In game one of the finals, the Las Vegas Aces beat the Sun 67-64 to take a 1-0 series lead.
In NCAA football, Illinois beat Virginia to move to 2-1 on the season. They will play Chattanooga next Thursday as they have the week off this week.
Well, that is all for this week, MMS. We will see you next week.
The maker of drawings, the designer of images, and presenter of logos has another amazing logo ready to blow your mind in this week's Logo Roundup.
Hello, MMS. Welcome back to Logo for Season 10. Today I'll be talking about the Stanley Cup champs, Colorado Avalanche. The logo includes the letter A resembling a mountain with a hockey puck racing down in an avalanche. The team has had three logos since 1972 when the team made their debut. The current logo has been with the team since 1995. The team has actually only been the Avalanche since 1995 as they were rebranded to become the Avalanche after being the Quebec Nordiques from 1972 to 1995. That is all for this week, MMS. See you next week.
We go now to some of our newest reporters as they try to create the first top three list to blow your mind.
Hey, I'm Trey.
And I'm Connor.
And this is
top three.
Today we'll be presenting the top three foods in the United States of America.
Number three is French fries.
Did you know that French fries weren't actually made in France?
Really?
Yeah, they were first made in Belgium.
That is really interesting.
Number two is pizza.
What? Pizza was invented in Italy as a way for poor people to reuse their scraps from meals to make new food so they could save on money.
Really?
Yeah.
Finally, the number one most popular food in the USA is burgers.
Did you know the name hamburger was derived from the Hamburg steaks brought to the USA by German immigrants?
That's so interesting. I had no idea.
And that is all.
See you next time
for another top three.
We randomly present more random randomness that is bursting with all the randomly random facts you randomly need to keep randomizing your random life. How random.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another great episode of MMS News. This week, I will be telling you all about the weird and wonderful facts from around the world. Did you know that Australia is so big, it's actually even wider than the moon? Did you also know that in summer, the Eiffel Tower can grow anywhere from 15 inches? It does this because of the heat. Now, this is completely off topic, but did you know that if for some reason you ate a large amount of nutmeg, you would actually end up hallucinating? Well, that's all the time I have today, MMS. See you next week. Season 10 is filled with amazing things like brand new stories, so let's see what some of our newest reporters have to offer this week.
Today we will be doing Would You Rather. So the Would You Rather question for today is, would you rather see 10 minutes into the future or 150 years into the future?
Well, for my answer, I think I'd rather see 150 years into the future.
Probably 10 minutes into the future.
I'd rather go 150 years into the future.
I would rather see 10 minutes into the future.
See 150 years into the future.
I would like to see 150 years into the future.
I would rather see 150 years in the future.
10 minutes into the future.
Years into the future, because 10 minutes, I know exactly where I'm going to be. But 150, I have no idea.
I would rather choose 10 minutes in the future, because you might create a time collapse or destroy the whole universe.
Alright, and the winner is 150 years. Thanks for watching. Bye.
Meming our meme into meme or meme rain is meme or memes meming memeing memory meme ever to meme memes meme world. Memoy.
Hello, MMS, and welcome back to memes. This week I couldn't find any memes because my mind is all fluttered, so I found you some random ones. First up is Hello Kids Cop. When you try hard at the food you're making and it doesn't actually come out the best. That's all, MMS. See you next week.
Have a great weekend and be safe, MMS. And remember to stay classy from at least 6 feet away. And wash your hands, please.
It was so weird.
over the side.
OMG.